Welcome to our video, Introducing Hotspot Mapping Using Kernel Density Estimation. We are looking here at burglaries in Leeds from Police UK data over a given time period. The map has been colour-coded in order to highlight locations in red where there is a disproportionate incidence of street crime. In this short video, we will show you how you can use Cadcorp SIS to create your own hotspot maps of any location-based incident data. The starting point for any hotspot map is a map showing the locations of the events or incidents of interest, represented as discrete points. Sometimes it is the details about individual events that are of most interest. A GIS allows you to click on individual points and drill down into that information. On other occasions, your interest may be on using GIS to help you grasp the big picture, the overall distribution of crime, for example. A point map is useful, but the raw data still requires a degree of visual interpretation for it to make sense. It might be helpful if you had a map showing the number or rate of incidents by area. This can be achieved through choropleth mapping. Such maps are especially useful when the administrative zones have some operational significance, such as the policing zones that a superintendent is responsible for staffing. However, they have a number of weaknesses. If the variable being mapped is a count rather than a rate, then there is often a case for normalizing the variable to take account of variations in the sizes of aerial units. Area shading can also be interpreted as implying that incidents in any one zone are distributed uniformly within the zone. This can be far from the truth, and there may even be a gradual change in incidents as one crosses a zonal boundary, not an abrupt one. Any difference in the size of aerial units can also mislead by making large zones shaded in the top threshold colour appear more prominent than smaller in the same range. It is a simple matter in GIS to remove the effect of variation in zone size by superimposing onto the point map a grid or quadrat of uniform cell size, and using this to count the number of incidents in each zone. But as you can see, depending on the size of the grid chosen, we can end up with a very blocky representation of the spatial distribution of crime, one that doesn't fit in with our intuitive understanding of it, and which conceals spatial detail. On the other hand, if you make the cell size too small, you can end up with a very speckled picture, in which most cells have a low or even zero incidence of crime. This is not much improvement on a map of raw point data. What we really need is a way to smooth the gridded image. It might seem that the problem is similar to that which often confronts terrain modellers. They have Z values or height values for a number of points on the terrain, and they want to interpolate Z values for those places where they haven't surveyed height values. In fact, it is not the same problem at all. With hotspot mapping, we are dealing with a probability surface, an estimate of the probability value on the count of incidents is not the same as an intensity or attribute value at a particular point. We will have white spaces on our maps, not because we haven't surveyed those areas, but because they are truly cool spots, where there have been zero incidents. We don't want to employ terrain modelling methods that allow distant points to create intensity values in the gaps between points. What we need is a technique for smoothing or averaging neighbouring cell values, which reflects our everyday experience that locations near to each other tend to be more similar than more distant locations, other things being equal. This method we suggest uses a local averaging technique known as Kernel Density Estimation, or KDE. It is a technique which has been used widely for smoothing blocky representations of frequency distributions, what we refer to as histograms. We are going to be using it to smooth their two-dimensional cartographic equivalent, grid maps. KDE provides an estimate of the proportion of total incidents that can be expected to occur in any given map location. It works by first overlaying an area of interest with a fine rectangular grid. It then calculates an estimate of the density of incidents in each grid cell, which is based on a weight function, the kernel. The kernel is a function of specified shape and bandwidth or search radius. It is defined to reflect the belief that there is a greater probability of an incident occurring in a given location the closer it is to the location of a known incident. We can visualize the kernel function as describing a mound-shaped volume, which we center at the location of each incident in our dataset. The influence of the incident on any grid cell location is measured by the height of the mound surface at the center of that grid cell. Where incidents are clustered, their respective mounds may overlap. The final density surface is calculated by taking account of the aggregate influence of all incidents by summing the heights of the mound surfaces at each cell. Cadcorp's implementation of KDE allows for three parameters to be specified. These are the following: grid cell size, bandwidth, that is the search radius of the kernel density function, and the shape of the kernel density function. Other things being equal, a finer grid cell size will provide more visually appealing smooth surfaces. However, this may be at the expense of data processing speeds, as larger data volumes are involved. A large bandwidth will spread the influence of points over a greater area. This may be more appropriate for strategic analysis, but less appropriate for local analysis. Too large a bandwidth will suppress spatial variation. If it is too small, it will not produce a continuous smooth surface. A flatter kernel function will also result in a more uniform distribution. In general, the bandwidth of the kernel function density estimation often proves to be more influential to outcomes than the kernel shape. This is not the place to discuss the precise specification of values for these three variables in different situations. This will depend on the theory and application behind the map, the scale at which the analysis is being conducted, and the target audience. Instead, we will focus on the process by which you can easily achieve hotspot mapping using Cadcorp SIS software. We shall now go through the process of creating a KDE hotspot. We start off by selecting a point dataset, with each point representing a crime location. Select all of the points on your overlay using the Select All button, or by right-clicking over the overlay name and choosing Select Items. Once the incident data is selected, we can then run the analysis. In Cadcorp SIS Map Modeler, select the Analysis tab and choose KDE Hotspot. The first dialog allows the user to choose a cell size and origin of the resultant grid item. The cell size options set the size of the grid cells in meters. Smaller cell size values will create a higher resolution grid, but the grid will take longer to generate. Therefore, clicking Next to progress through the dialog will take longer than with larger cell size values. After selecting the cell size and origin of the grid, the Create Hotspot Grid dialog will be displayed. The value in the Hotspot Values option will exaggerate the grid cell values being created. To select a property or formula, press the FX button to bring up the formula dialog. This input is optional and can be left at none if appropriate. There is a choice of 9 different kernel functions to be used to create the grid item. Different kernel functions smooth the data differently with regard to the weighting of importance applied to each point. For this example, we shall be using the normal distribution, which is the most commonly applied kernel function. The next option is to choose which type of grid to create: probability, relative density, or absolute density grid. After choosing the grid, the bandwidth needs to be set. This is a smoothing parameter, which helps important patterns in the data to be captured. The larger the number, the greater the smoothing effect. The next dialog displays some statistics and allows the grid items to be styled. Predefined color sets can be chosen, or individual value sets can be created. The final dialog allows you to choose where the grid item will be created: on an existing editable overlay, or on a new overlay. By selecting Finish, your new KDE hotspot grid will be created. By comparing our new hotspot maps to the original choropleth map, we can see the limitations of choropleth mapping by showing that the hotspot sits completely 50-50 over ward boundaries. We can also compare the results of using different kernel functions by creating overlays for each type. And we can also investigate the differing results produced by using different bandwidths. Thank you for watching our video.